Hello guys, today I'll be reviewing Among the Living by Anthrax, and this review was requested by Christian Perez. Thank you for the request. And yeah, this album, of course, it's often hailed as one of their best, or even their best, or at the top. And yeah, this album or Spreading the Disease is the best for me personally. They both fight for the number one spot as my favorite Anthrax album, but this album's excellent. Out of all their 80s albums, this one probably has the best production, and yeah, it's an album that still holds up today. Definitely one of the more popular albums from the thrash metal scene, and yeah, all around still a great album, and still one of their best in my opinion. But anyways, let's go ahead and dive into the album. The album starts off with Among the Living, and I believe the song, it was either inspired or it was a tribute to a novel that Stephen King wrote. I can't remember the name of it, but this song, it's always been one of my personal favorites on the album. I like the slow guitar intro, eventually leading into some guitar riffs that have some interesting groove to them. Eventually, you get to some more thrashy moments, such as in the verses, and this song all around is catchy. You definitely get plenty of things in terms of rhythm and speed, because you have your more mid-tempo or groovy moments, while you also have your more thrashy moments. And this song all around is great and a solid album opener in my opinion. But then we get to the song Caught in a Mosh, which is basically a mosh pit anthem at this point. The song is a fan favorite. You'll see it in greatest hit compilations from this band, and understandably so. It's definitely a great song, one of the most popular songs from them. It's thrashy, catchy, and all around memorable track, especially the chorus. But yeah, this song is just a blast to listen to, and same with the next song, I Am the Law, which is of course about Judge Dredd. I believe they did another song about Judge Dredd in the previous album, Lone Justice, if I got the song right, but I Am the Law, another really catchy song. You have your more mid-tempo moments, your more thrashy moments, and it's another fan favorite from the album, and understandably so, another really good song on the album. Then we get to Efel Nikifesen, NFL, I probably pronounced that incorrectly, but no, it isn't actually about NFL or football. It's actually about the actor John Belushi and his drug use and many other things that he did in his life. And this song, another fan favorite from the band in their discography. And the guitar work definitely stands out in this song to me personally, especially in the verses. And yes, there's some riffs in the song that definitely have some nice grit to them, some nice punch too, and the chorus is also memorable. Yeah, this is another song that I still really enjoy. I mean, you really can't go wrong with the first half of the album. I mean, the first half is basically untouchable. There's no weak moments in any of the first half. But then we get to the song A Skeleton in the Closet, which is definitely another favorite of mine on the album. It has one of my favorite intros slash build-ups on the album, maybe in Anthrax's discography in general, out of all their songs. I mean, in this song, you can really hear the greatness in Charlie Benante's drum work, especially during the verses. I mean, his drumming, you can really notice in this song and really hear. But basically everyone in the song really shines. There's really no one taking the spotlight to themselves. I mean, everyone is really just giving it their all on this song, especially Charlie and Scott Ian. But yeah, this song all around is just great. It's a 5.5 minutes long. Doesn't feel too long. I still think the build-up is maybe one of my favorite moments on the album. All around a great track. And I believe that's another song that was inspired or a tribute to one of Stephen King's novels, because I know Anthrax, the members of Anthrax, are big fans of Stephen King. But then we get to the song that got me into Anthrax, the song Indians. Still one of my favorite songs from them to this day. I was instantly hooked from the drum intro, and The song, lyrically, if I remember correctly, deals with mistreatment of Indians or Native Americans. And with this album in general, you have your more mature lyrics and your more lighthearted or fun lyrics, which you can see in songs like I'm the Law, for example. But Indians, lyrically, is a more serious song, or it tackles a more serious topic. And this song is, of course, to no surprise, one of my favorites on the album, because, of course, it was the song that got me into them. And this is another song where you definitely notice the greatness of Charlie Benante with his drum work. And you also get some pretty memorable guitarists in the song, too, especially leading up to the first verse. But yeah, Indians, definitely a great song. But then we get to, in my opinion, one of the most underrated Anthrax songs, One World. This song, all around, is a thrashy, fun banger, and the chorus is super catchy. And yeah, it's a hair under 6 minutes, but it also doesn't feel like 6 minutes either. So when you manage to do something like that, you're definitely doing something right. But yeah, One World, definitely one of the most underrated songs. And if you like the thrashy side of Anthrax, you'll definitely have no problem liking this song. But next we have the song ADI, Whore of It All. And ADI, I believe, stands for Arabian Douche Intro. I recently discovered that and thought that was kind of interesting. But yeah, the song starts off with some kind of Middle Eastern sounding acoustic intro, eventually leading into some more heavier riffs and thrashy riffs and tempos and stuff like that when we get to the Whore of It All part of the song. But yeah, I believe the intro is like around a minute long before getting into Horror of It All. And I believe Horror of It All is about Cliff's death. I could be wrong, but I read about that somewhere recently. But the song is 7 minutes and 50 seconds, and it doesn't feel that long either. Another song that does a great job at not overstaying its welcome, or another song that you could say where you can't really feel the song length. But yeah, this song is pretty dang good. Again, you have your more mid-tempo moments, such as in the verses, and then you have your more thrashy moments, such as around the 6 minute mark, like 6:05 minute mark. But this is another pretty good song. Maybe another more underrated song from them, because it's not talked about as much as some of the other songs on the album. Now, I don't know if it's one of my favorites on the album, but I do like it though overall. Then we get to the song Imitation of Life, and this song is a reworked version of a SOD song, if I remember correctly. SOD is a band that I'm not too familiar with. I mean, I know what they are, and I have heard some of their songs, but again, not a band that I'm super familiar with, so maybe I'll look into them at some point. But Imitation of Life, another thrashy banger, and it's another song that's fairly a blast to listen to. A bit more on the shorter side, at least in terms of this album. It's the shortest song on the album. It's 4 minutes and 10 seconds. And yeah, the song just comes and goes, and it's just a thrashy, fun blast of a song. And you have some riffs that definitely feel raw and have some nice grit to them, which definitely makes the song a bit more powerful too. Now, I'll be honest, it's not one of my favorites on the album, but it's still a pretty good song and not a bad album closer. But anyways, if I had to rate this album, I'd probably give it maybe a 9.5. This album is pretty strong and definitely one of the best albums to come from thrash metal. But anyways, let me know your thoughts on the album. Do you love it? Do you hate it? How does it compare to the other albums for you personally? And all that good stuff. But anyways, thanks for watching. Please give a comment, like, subscribe. Have a nice day, and take care.